Good evening. My name's Michael, and I'm going to talk to you about how to paginate anything with AngularJS. So when we're building a typical browser-based app, I propose that a large part of what we spend our time doing can be distilled down to two things: forms and lists. And when your app is displaying a list, usually it'll want to display more data than can comfortably fit on one page. So for that reason, pagination is everywhere. Now, when people first get into AngularJS, I think it's pretty common for them to have a kind of a wow moment when they first get a glimpse of the power of the framework. Like when you first go to the homepage and you see the two-way data binding examples. For me, one of these wow moments came when I learned how to use the ng repeat directive. So as you all know, it's the thing that drives any kind of list or table of data in your Angular app. And it gives you this expression which you can use to filter, to sort, to otherwise transform the collection in a number of ways. It's super powerful. Now, imagine for a second if you could harness the power of ng repeat, and then you could have it automatically paginate itself and generate pagination links on the fly, which update themselves as the collection changes with filters and so on. And all of this without having to write a single line of code in your controller. How powerful would that be? For those who don't know, this is Dr. Manhattan. He's pretty powerful. Okay, so let's take a quick look how this could be done. So in honor of this wonderful city that's hosting us this week, I have a little demo app, a famous Parisians list. So as you can imagine, it can be filtered in a couple of different ways. Let's see who's still alive. Brigitte Bardot, good. It can be sorted. Okay, pretty straightforward. Let's look at the code for a second. So the controller is like the most simple controller you can imagine. We're just loading the people data into the view model. And everything else is done with this repeat statement right here, which is a fairly typical repeat statement. Okay, so we want to be Dr. Manhattan. So what we want to be able to do would be something like this. Just drop a directive here which will represent the pagination links. And we want those to know about what's going on in this expression. Well, ng-repeat won't tell us that out of the box, so let's replace it with this custom directive I've written. And finally, we'll just add another filter here. Tell it how many items we want per page. Let's say 4. Okay, let's have a look. It worked. So, voila. So you've got your pagination links automatically generated right here. The filtering works as you would expect. And I just want you to notice that as I start to filter it, the links will automatically update themselves in real time, and sorting works as you would expect. And just to reiterate, I did nothing in the controller. I just added a couple of directives and I added a filter. Okay, so, all right, maybe I exaggerated. You don't become a godlike super being with this, but it will save you some time if you use it. It's well tested. It comes with a bunch of useful features. So it supports server-side paging for those times when you have tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of items in your collection. You don't necessarily want to do them all in memory. You can have multiple instances in your view. You can have any number of these pagination instances, and they'll all operate independently of one another. It supports multi-element items, so just like ng repeat start and end, you can use it in exactly the same way if you wanted, for example, to output 2 table rows per item. And much more. So check it out. This shortened link will take you to the GitHub repo. You can install it via Bower with this command here, angular-utils-pagination. And I invite you to try it out in your current or your next project. I hope it saves you some time and can make your life as an Angular developer even easier. Thank you.